Good morning, children. Once again, I came back for you to teach third lesson. Seventh class, third lesson. Science. The lesson name is Animal Fibers. What is the lesson name? Animal Fibers. Before going to lesson, generally I will ask you every time what are our basic needs, important needs to live on this earth means. You know already, we need air, we need water, we need food. We know that, but also we need shelter to live one place, and we need clothes also to protect from heat, rain, cold, and also for to cover our body. Clothes need to cover our body and for good looking also. Whenever we wear that on your birthdays, especially you come in colorful dress, then we say just we are looking very good today. You are very pretty, like so. For good looking also, we need clothes. And how do we get these clothes? Means if you think once, why? How do we get these clothes? Means we get these clothes from fibers. Fibers are the main source to make clothes. So these fibers are. Where do we get these fibers? Means we get fibers from plants and from animals. And also some minerals also, and we get fibers from plants and animals. This is, you know, already simple. And from plants, best example, cotton plant. We see many cotton plants now in our nearby fields. That from that cotton we can get thread. With that help of thread, in factories they made clothes. So we get cotton from plants. And also jute, and these are the some examples. From animals we get especially, which is very costly, silk clothes. On occasions we wear, you know, that silk, the costly silk clothes are made from silkworm. In this lesson we are going to learn detailed manner about silkworm. And also woolen clothes in winter season. In this winter seasons we wear woolen clothes, no? Woolen blankets, woolen clothes, monkey caps, sweaters. All these woolen are made from wool. There we get wool from sheep or goat, you know, already from camels. In this detailed manner we can learn in this lesson. And already fibers are two types. Fibers are two types. What are the two types of fibers? One is natural fibers and man-made fibers. Natural, in the name only itself, we get from nature. God has given some gifts in the nature. From in the nature only we get some fibers from plants and animals. They are called natural fibers. Example, cotton, jute, silk, wool. All these best examples for natural fibers. And man-made fibers, in the name only have the meaning. Man-made, in the factories, in the industries made, that are fibers are called man-made fibers. Examples, nylon, polyester, which are very transparent and we are wearing in other seasons, no? In fancy type of clothes we wear, no? These type of clothes are called man-made fibers. Example, nylon, polyester, rayon, like this type of clothes. We can see man-made fibers. And before the lesson, I will introduce you some key words. Understand? Some key words. Keywords, silk moth. Already I tell, no, from silk we get silk from silkworm. That silkworm only in the larva stage we can say silk moth, which is stocky, creamy, white moth. We can see creamy white color, that worm, simple silkworm. It grows again under the pupa stage, that is caterpillar. And this stage is called silk moth. It grows on human care, under human care, because silk is very costly, no? So some people, farmers, in their occupation, they do work hard and they raise some silk moths. So always silk moths grows under human care. And sericulture. Sericulture is like agriculture. Sericulture also an occupation. In sericulture, some people, group of people works under their hard work the rail silk from silk mass. Rail silk mass and obtain raw silk. In sericulture, what they will do? They will get mulberry leaves. Mulberry is one crop. From that mulberry plants will be there. From that plants, they will cut the all the leaves and they will keep as food to silk moths. By eating the leaves of mulberry leaves, by eating that leaves, they are rearing. They start rearing. With that, they get raw silk. This process, whole process, is called sericulture. And cocoons are nothing but that silk moss made someone like nest in the oval shaped nest. With that cocoon only, we get thread. So, this is called cocoon. A protective frame or case as fibrous material. We get fiber from these cocoons only. And Bambix mori. This is called scientific name of silkworms. It's actually, this silk is invented first from China. In detailed manner we can learn. And reeling is obtaining silk from cocoon. From cocoons we have to take out the silk, you know, thread. That process is called reeling. And fleece means nothing but the coat or skin of the sheep or goat is called fleece. From this only we get wool or thread. And knitting means in the tailor also knit with the help of thread and needle. Same like that, knitting means needle work. Understand? And coming to the mind mapping, animal fibers, plant fibers, we can also call as vegetable fibers. So there are two types of fibers, animal fibers are protein based and vegetable fibers are carbohydrate based fibers. So animal fibers and plant fibers are vegetable fibers. Animal fibers example silk and wool. And vegetable fibers example cotton, linen, jute also we can say like examples. In this lesson we are going to learn detailed manner how to get silk from silkworm. Rearing of silk. So in this some stages are there. Here is mind mapping. For example, how we get silk from first eggs of silk moth, and they changes into moth stage, and from that they frame one cocoon around the moth. They frame one cocoon. From that cocoon only we take thread by reeling. This is one stage, and from that we get yarn. Yarning means we get thread. After that, weavers make weaving. From this weaving we get some clothes. For example, you take sari or any cloth made up by weaving only. This is the last stage. So in this, how we get silk means these are the stages: eggs, moth, cocoons, reeling, yarn and weaving. Very very important. And in this your lesson, this is also a detailed manner. Woolen fibers. Woolen fibers we get from sheep or wool or sheep or goat or camel, I said, no. So in this lesson, these are the stages. See how many stages? Almost all 10 stages are there. How we get wool means first shedding and scouring and sorting and bleaching, dyeing, combing, spinning, weaving, knitting, rolling and twisting also. At last we get woolen fabric. So these are the 10 stages almost all. After this hard work only we get wool. See how much hard work behind the making cloth. That is not easy. Wearing, buying from the shop, purchasing and wearing cloths is not, that is easy. We can enjoying them. But behind that, number of people, hard work is behind this making woolen fibers. So many stages are there. So from plants and animals, we get fibers. Understand? This is the simple introduction of the lesson. And I will give you some more videos and I will explain complete the lesson. You have to understand well. Thank you.